one of our best guys, Leon Higachi, is holed up in the bank with a voomer.
He's not gonna be able to handle it on his own. Get in there and help him fast, or there's not gonna be much...
You're trembling. Are you gonna shoot me? You got what it takes? You're just an ordinary cop, not an AD police pig. I don't think you've got the guts. So first I'm gonna fuck you. Then I'll kill you.
Higachi, in view of your exceptional bravery in fighting a boomer, you are hereby transferred to the AD police.
Thank you. Those bullets won't stop her!
We'll see. Take this, bitch!
An AD police detachment on its way. Do not try to restrain the boomer till they arrive. All units, stand by.
This doesn't look like a normal criminal, Boomer. She's gone completely crazy. Looks like one of the Mark IV type.
We can handle her without extra assistance.
How you doing, Rookie? You ain't gonna shit yourself.
Hope not.
Are you the owner of this crazy boomer?
Yes. What is?
I need your authority to demolish the renegade.
Okay.
Come on, sign. The owner's okayed it, boy, so get in there and take her out.
Yes, sir.
Hey! Shame we gotta waste one they made as good-looking as this one is, huh?
Just remember what she is underneath. Hold her down while I cut her nerve circuits. Don't let go! Hold tight, idiot!
Destroyed. There's your receipt.
A Voomer is an android created from protein, man-made internal organs, and given artificial intelligence. There have recently been cases of this intelligence malfunctioning in early models, but insanity has not been previously recorded in a Mark IV.
What do you want?
I'm sick about Alice getting killed. It's my fault that he died. I just know that I fucked up.
Maybe you did, but I expect a bit more than an apology. How about something practical?
Huh?
You can give me what Alice used to. Can you do that? You see, Rookie, Every time I come back here after going on an operation, I need a little help to unwind.
I hope I'm not interrupting, but I've got to talk about Alice's life assurance.
Look, every member of the AD police is covered by special hazard insurance, so just pay it.
Well, it's complicated. We did a detailed analysis on the boomer that killed him. We found no abnormality whatsoever in her circuitry. In fact, the only thing of note was that while she was designed to serve a maximum 12-hour shift, her owner was keeping her going a full 24 hours at a time.
What's your problem, rookie? Don't you eat either?
When we got this problem sorted out.
I'll have it then.
It turns out that Alice had gambling debts in every whorehouse in town, and the boys were getting impatient. He also had private life assurance of 7 million yen.
Yeah, he told me he had a little stashed away.
And finally, we have a witness who says that on the day of his death, Alice had gone to the restaurant and made contact with the boomer. Unauthorized contact, you know what I mean?
Hold on there. Are you saying Alice had arranged his own killing at the restaurant to collect the insurance?
I think I'd rather not say anything else now.
Alice wasn't the kind of guy to pull a scam like that.
Suppose we could find another case of a Mark IV that went insane. Then you'd have to agree that Alice's death wasn't set up, but just in the line of duty.
Yes, I agree. That would be persuasive.
Okay, then. We'll check it out. And if we find any Mark IVs have gone nuts, but that it wasn't serious enough to go on the police computer, then you'll pay.
Yeah, that's a deal. Only, I'll need an answer in the next 8 hours.
Oh, my arm!
Thinking.
Well, I was hoping I might live long enough to complete this inquiry.
Shut up. Alice was the best, yet he let some crazy Mark IV knock him off. Hey, rookie, I've been wondering why you didn't want to screw me.
I wanted to. But before I got transferred to the AD police, I was attacked by a boomer who'd gone insane. One of the latest models, equipped with vocal cords, a Mark VIII.
So even a Mark VIII could go insane.
They analyzed her before they resuscitated her, and found that it was possible under extreme stress, like if she had the hots for someone or a death wish, something like that.
I can understand that. The Mark VIII's are practically human women, and I know how women can feel.
Wait a minute! Suppose the Mark IV that killed Alice was a resuscitation job, too. One that went wrong.
Illegal resuscitation, that's a possibility. Let's check it out.
Buddy boy, it's me.
What the hell is this place?
Well, well, it's been a while. What can I do for you, Gina?
You can tell me about illegal boomer resuscitation. I want to know about Mark IVs.
Well, that's a touchy subject.
Don't fuck with me. I don't have much time.
Okay, Mark IVs. course, Mark IVs are pretty outdated. There's only a handful left in Mega Tokyo. They were useful up to a point. They'd do domestic chores all day without complaining. But customers got bored with that, so the company widened the function parameters on later marks. But then owners felt threatened. They wanted the outdated, uncomplaining kind back, so junk dealers broke old ones for spares and resuscitated them.
Why?
Well, obviously, if you could build a model that'd do the housework without complaining and give sex as well, you'd make a fortune. Though it might put pretty heavy pressure on the boomer.
Heavy enough to drive it insane.
Well, I'm not saying that. But look at it this way. If you equip a subservient boomer that's only programmed to do housework with sexual impulses, it makes some pretty confusing demands on the biochips you got in the original function planning, which might, in some circumstances, upset the whole system. But still, there are junk dealers doing this kind of work. I'll give you a list of them. But be careful. They're very dangerous men.
Thanks, buddy.
We started checking the resuscitation workshops, the not-so-legal ones. But we couldn't link any of them to the boomer that killed Alice. Gina and I were getting tense. Time was running out.
Leon, look at this.
Huh? What is it? Looks like a break-in.
Yeah, right on the next block. Let's go.
Hold it. I can handle it alone. You carry on checking the names on the resuscitation list. We don't have much time left.
At last I've got you alone. Have you forgotten me? I haven't forgotten you. You owe me. You owe me for not finishing me off. Do you know what happened to me? The cops analyzed me. They tore me apart, examined every bit of me. But I was still alive. I remember.
I want to see everything you've got on the Mark IV model.
Mark IV? There must be some mistake. I don't know anything about Mark IVs. I'm not licensed to work on them.
That's a pity. They say there's a lot of money to be made out of resuscitating Mark IVs.
So I believe.
Don't get clever. I can make your life very uncomfortable.
I'm willing to cooperate.
So do it, then.
Sure. Okay, keep cool.
Just don't forget, the AD police could have this workshop closed down. What the fuck's this?
Sorry, you got the wrong guy. I ain't got no money. And I don't pay for it anyway. Wasting your time, honey.
Why can't I speak? Don't you remember? They tore my body apart. Shoot me again. Kill me this time. I don't want this. Kill me. If you don't, I'll... It's all I know how to do. I can't take any more. Kill me.
Admit it. Don't shoot. I've worked on a few Mach 4s in my time, but none of them committed a crime. I'm positive of that. You see, there's a big demand for combination boomers. The trick is to get the balance just right.
Hold it. Go back a little. Stop! Is that one resuscitated?
Yeah, she's pure Mark 8. They brought her into me damn near dead, and I went to work to remove all the undesirables in her and make her acceptable and usable.
She's back in circulation?
Hmm?
And you used parts you'd taken out of an earlier model?
That was the whole point. But I'll be honest with you. There was one image, one memory. I don't know what it was. I couldn't erase.
Don't send me back to the workshop. Please. Please.
Proved that the dealer Gina had talked to had resuscitated the boomer which had killed Alice, and his family got his hazard insurance. I'll never know if that Mark 8 was about to kill me or kiss me, but her poor mutilated remains seem to me to sum up everything we've created in this soulless, savage city.
I've never realized what I've given up for you. You never gave me the chance to be what I want and to love you as I am. The life of love you never gave me doesn't stop me from wanting you. And all the crazy lies you told me doesn't stop me from loving you. What a fool I am. What a fool. Still in my heart I hold this everlasting love. If only you could look into my heart. If only you could feel the love I have. Then maybe you'll come to realize there's one in a million me. Still I come to want you. Still I come to need you. Still I come. What a fool I am.
Are you expensive?
I don't do anything kinky. I just do straight sex. There are plenty of other girls around.
How old are you?
16. 16, that's all.
Something wrong with your eye?
Yeah, it's been hurting lately.
So trade it in for an artificial one.
Why do you think she went down there?
A lot of working girls are using Paradise Loop these days. There seems to be something about the subway which draws them to it.
Well, it beats me why any girl would want to spend time down in the loop.
For a cop as good as you are, Iris, you sure are naive.
Paradise Loop is the city's old subway system. When the electromagnetic metro was opened 10 years ago, the loop fell into disuse. But the electric current was never shut off, and a few trains were kept in service for running mail across the city or picking up late-night stragglers with no other way to get home. It's become a magnet for all kinds of crime.
What happened exactly?
Her abdomen was ripped open. Blood everywhere. She must have died at once.
Do you know who she was?
Not so far, but apparently she'd been around for 6 months or so.
Hey, you guys! What are you doing here? Who called the AD police? There aren't any boomers here.
Maybe not, but the chief thought it wouldn't hurt for us to have a look around. There have been an awful lot of murders on the loop, and you guys haven't had much success in solving them.
We're working on it.
Nobody's saying you ain't doing the best you can, but we got resources and equipment you can't even dream about, and that's why they assigned us to the case.
Wait a minute. The city formed the AD police to investigate crimes that are down to political terrorists and boomers, not ordinary murders. And whenever your boys get involved in some ordinary investigation, you end up by doing more damage to people and property than the criminals.
Let me guess. You're one of those cops who believes in wearing kid gloves, right?
I'd never ridden the Paradise Loop. In fact, that was the first time I'd even been on a loop station. It was horrible.
All six victims were prostitutes working Paradise Loop. All were killed in the same way. The murders are quite obviously linked. The savagery of the attack strongly suggests that they are the work of a renegade boomer. If that is the case, then there must be some defect in its intelligence system. A very dangerous situation, yes?
But why would it murder them?
It's possible. The original program included aggressiveness, which can have its positive sides, but on this occasion he's out of control. On the assumption, then, that we're dealing with a renegade Voomer, I'm turning over responsibility for the investigation to the AD police. Yes, Lieutenant Kara?
Chief, I'm convinced we're not after a Voomer, but a human being. It's a hunch, but I've got some reasons. Although the medical reports refer to mutilation of the abdomen, the mutilated parts of the bodies could more accurately be described as the internal sexual organ. A Voomer wouldn't have reason to feel a motive towards these particular parts.
Anyone else have any comment?
I think that makes sense. It'd be a mistake to completely rule out the possibility of a human killer.
Okay, then. I'll keep your force on the case for a bit longer, working with the AD police.
That's fine. Thanks for your support.
That's okay. It's an interesting case. But I'm surprised that you want to stay on it, though. Is it still hurting you?
A bit, yeah.
You gotta make an appointment with some cybernetic specialist who'll prescribe a replacement for you. Look at this finger. Bet you wouldn't have guessed it's a cybernetic replacement. Come on, be with it. Everybody does it these days.
Cybernetics Bank, Tokyo.
Stop it. You didn't have to come here, you know.
But it was my fault that you got hurt.
It was just an accident. It wasn't your fault, so calm down.
Huh? Excuse me a sec.
What's wrong?
I'll be right back. What are you doing here?
Leon!
You haven't come to the hospital to get any parts replaced.
Well,
Are you
yes.
crazy? Don't you know what they do here? They replace human organs with cybernetic substitutes. Your guts go into the bank, get resuscitated, and when some zillionaire needs a transplant, they sell in your insides.
My eye's giving me a bit of trouble, so I'm having it replaced. What's wrong with that?
What does it matter if it hurts you a bit? Being hurt is all part of being human. If you give away part of your body, you're not completely human anymore.
You mustn't be old-fashioned, Leon. We're in the 21st century. Everyone makes use of cybernetics.
There's a chance the pain will get more severe. On the other hand, it might disappear altogether. I always encourage patients to have the operation when there's any discomfort at all. After all, this is the 21st century, and we all have a right to a trouble-free life. So if you care to choose...
Oh!
What do you mean it can't be done? If it's a question of money, I can pay whatever it costs.
It's not a question of money. It's impossible. You've been in your present condition too long for us to replace your cybernetic organs with living ones. You simply wouldn't be able to function.
Ah!
chasing, for God's sake!
She's turning off to the right!
Are you gonna tell us what's going on or not?
I've got a hunch about the prostitute murderer.
Oh.
That woman. Oh. Oh. I'm very sorry.
These cyber doctors.
What?
They're all heartless. I take it you heard me shouting.
No.
They don't care how much we suffer. Well, someone's going to pay. Take care.
Why did she come here?
Because there's no one left in this part of town. They'll be tearing it down soon. She knew she could hide here.
Legs ain't bad.
What was that?
You're over a ventilation shaft. The paradise loop's right beneath you.
Someone's going to pay for this.
Yeah, tell the chief it looks like the same boomer again.
Caroline Ibachi, chief executive of Green.
Green?
The tastiest snack you've ever seen is cream and sugar on grits by Green.
Oh.
She's a brilliant businesswoman. Married some toy boy 6 months ago. No one ever sees him, though. They say she keeps him in the bedroom waiting for her to get home at night. She had the operation 5 years ago. Kidneys replaced, liver, ovaries, womb, the whole works from the waist down. Nothing to stop her screwing, though. Looks like the operation worked for her. She's become president of the company, and her salary is supposed to be about $12 million a year. I wouldn't mind being in her shoes. We're wasting our time sitting here watching her. We can't link her with the murderers.
Maybe not, but I got a real buzz from her at the cyber hospital.
Are you a lesbian?
Huh?
Look who's blushing.
Don't be silly.
Just kidding. But maybe we ought to report your hunch to the AD police.
There's no proof.
That store over there's got a sale on. Do you mind if I go and take a quick look?
No, that's okay.
Back in 10 minutes.
Bye.
Oh!
wonder where I'm going. Where will this tunnel lead me?
To the Paradise Loop.
I saw you following me here. Does this satisfy your fatal curiosity? Well, well, well. So the pretty thing turns out to be a cop, huh?
That's right. And you're the Paradise Loop murderer.
Yes.
I don't understand why.
Still curious, huh? Well, I'll tell you. A few years ago, I applied for a job in the company. I was shortlisted with a man. I was better qualified in every way. I was smarter, better educated, and worked twice as hard. But he got the job. Do you know why? He put together a medical profile on women's menstrual cycles. He presented so-called evidence that some women behave irrationally during their periods and persuaded the president that I wouldn't be able to work efficiently during those times. Do you know what I did? I got the doctors to remove all the internal organs that made me female. Everything was replaced by asexual cybernetic machinery. And it worked. I became successful. But I wanted revenge against the man who betrayed me. I still had the only things most men want and used them to trap him into marrying me so I could make his life hell. But it didn't work out as I'd planned because I actually fell in love with him and forgot the reason I'd married him. But then he started being unfaithful to me and even came to Paradise Loop to have sex with the prostitutes here. He told me a real woman was better than the cybernetic monster I'd become.
So you killed him, didn't you? But why all the prostitutes? What had they done to you?
You won't understand. Sometimes I'm in incredible pain. It's as though my body is paying me back for the outrage I inflicted on it. And when it's over, when I recover, I'm always holding a knife. And then my whole body's on fire and only an act of violence leads to relief. Tell me the truth. Am I human or a Voomer?
You're a woman. I know that for certain. Voomers can kill when programs go wrong, but only humans kill because they're angry or jealous.
Yes, you're right. Thank you. I understand the terrible things I've done, and I realize that there's no going back. So I'll kill the human you say I am.
Ah! But you must die first!
She's mad. She's gonna commit suicide.
That's okay with me. One less boomer for us to worry about, and that's gotta be good news.
Where is she?
Trying to escape, but the exits are all covered, and the loop goes round in circles.
We'll take over now. Go back up top and get some rest. You've had a bad time.
I'm not finished yet. I followed her here, and it's my job to arrest her, not yours.
She's a killer.
Maybe, but a human being.
What's the difference?
Anyone can see that without me explaining it. She is human.
What she is a Voomeroid. According to the book, that means we treat her as a Voomer. We've got men positioned all round the loop. Standing orders are to shoot on sight.
You can't, Leon!
According to our computer records, she chose to replace 70% of her critical internal organs cybernetically. That puts her over the edge. This is a test case for the new Voomer laws that come into effect next month.
I've located her. She's at the east end of the loop. There's a train just pulling in there.
What are you talking about? I don't understand. What's 70% got to do with it when her mind's still got 100% human feeling? There's a whole lot more to being a human than just bits of skin and bone.
Boomers get no pain. The pain that I feel.
Leon.
I'm a human being. A woman.
Show us what you got, baby.
Come on. I'll prove it.
She should have died happy. She died as a woman, not a boomer.
But the trouble is that every day it's becoming harder to tell the difference, and pretty soon there won't be one. Hey, look after yourself, okay?
You're sure you want us to go ahead with the operation?
Yes.
I think that's wise. It won't take a minute.
The pain vanished, but I had paid a price. I'd given up part of my humanity.
Thank you. Hey, Billy. Just got word through there's a boomer gone berserk a couple of blocks away. Hey, Billy, you hear me?
Got it, Hyde. I can handle it.
I know you can, Captain.
I am not capable of feeling pain. Every item of input into my brain is pure information. Sometimes it's as if I'm floating, suspended weightlessly. When I am in this state of unbeing, I bite my tongue. It is the only living part of my body. The pain I feel biting it is the only proof of my humanity. My name is Billy Fernwood. I am the captain of AD Police Unit G4. I'm also the prototype anti-Voomer experimental cyborg.
Six of my best guys already. It's getting too hot for us. Send in Unit G4.
All yours, Billy.
Dayok, pull your men back. They'll only get in my way.
Get back, men! Back up!
Me. Jeez, will you look at that?
Did he have to stomp all over it like that?
Whatever turns you on, man.
You're hurt, Billy. Are you okay?
He ain't hurt, just a couple of dents in his plating.
He's gotten playing weird lately. He never used to be sadistic
Billy,
like
Billy,
that.
Billy, it's Gina. Ain't she even gonna say hello?
Billy, what the hell is going on? It took you 87 seconds to destroy that boomer.
Doctor, there's no point in scalding him.
Doctor, please don't interfere. You know as well as I do that there's been a significant deterioration in Billy's performance. When he fights now, he's not applying himself properly to the job in hand.
The trouble is the residue of humanity in him. Don't forget, Bill is not a complete cyborg. We're experimenting with a complicated human mind.
No, it's purely a mechanical malfunction. Certain nerve ends aren't fusing properly.
I don't think it's that simple. It may apply to his brain, but not to his mind. His body is almost entirely computer-controlled. The only function of his brain is to give that computer instructions. But what if his mind intrudes?
Then it must be neutralized.
It'd be sensible to eradicate his memory.
For who? For Billy?
Hey, Billy. Oh! Ah! Oh. Billy. Leon, what do you think of Billy?
Huh?
He's the only cyborg on the force. If it wasn't for him, we couldn't handle half the operations we do.
I get the feeling sometimes they're really using him.
He's been acting strange. He's been ignoring me. I mean, he won't even talk to me.
Do you know him well?
Yeah.
Huh? As well as that?
Yeah. I lived with him for a short while.
Well, then what do you feel about the doctors making him into a robot program to fight and kill Voomers all his life?
It scares me. Yeah, I feel real frightened about it. I keep thinking I might end up like Billy. When I got my artificial arm, it turned out to be not very energy efficient. It's joined up here to artificial nerves and fake cells, and I'm beginning to feel they're spreading all over me. It's as though unhuman things are taking over my whole body. That's kind of scary. Billy must feel the same way, no longer human. It's only a matter of time till the machine controls his heart. Shit, I'm sorry. Seeing Billy today the way he is got me real depressed.
Yeah.
Hey, drink up. Have another.
Sorry, but liquor and me just don't mix.
Oh, boy, what a shame. I hoped that if you drank enough, you'd take me home to your place.
Huh? Ahoo!
I'm all finished. You coming, Dr. Takagi?
Billy, I'm sorry I yelled at you. But you asked for it. It was your fault. You just gotta do what I want and I'll be good to you. There's never been a cyborg like you. And I made you, Billy. That beautiful body that can give me so much pleasure, even if you yourself can feel none, Billy.
I can't find anything wrong with his nerve endings. Everything's stable.
So what are you suggesting? That we have to start digging around in his brain?
Well, Dr. Manabi wondered if we'd given enough attention to his mind. Billy's been getting so much sensory stimulation, it could be unbalancing him. If he can no longer respond in the way he did as a human, it might be very confusing for him. And he's compensating for his limited emotional capability by overexploiting his received programmed input.
You could be right.
It's as though you'd built a tank with a brain, then turned off the faucet that kept the brain supplied with fuel.
So you think he needs more stimulation?
That's right. If he gets hit, he doesn't feel any pain. He knows he can't be destroyed in a fight, so the risk and excitement are gone. He becomes withdrawn. What is there left for him to respond to? What can excite him?
I'm gonna have to give this some serious personal attention.
I'm sure you'll find some answer to the problem.
I'll do whatever I have to do. I want Billy to function on all fronts. We'll begin by upping his dose of DA-27. That might wake him up.
That might be dangerous. It could lead to an uncontrollable explosion.
Well, even that'd be better than the killing zombie he's become. Increase the dose tomorrow. I'll give Billy the stimulation he wants.
What's
wrong? You look upset.
No, I'm okay.
You concerned about Billy? Half the time, he doesn't say a word to any of his old friends. And now, when he fights, he's become so brutal, it worries me. What have they done with him?
He's fighting as if killing boomers is fun, as if he gets kicks out of it.
Mm-hmm.
I was told you wanted to see me.
That's right. Something's happening to Billy, and I want to know what it is.
I don't have to answer to you.
Are you pumping drugs into him?
What do you mean?
Come on, don't play all innocent. Billy's completely different to what he was when you first got your sticky fingers on him.
Well, of course he is. My instructions were to produce a cyborg which could eliminate Voomers efficiently. Billy saw the necessity for that and cooperated fully and willingly. I agree there have been one or two small difficulties, but now I'd say he's completely normal.
It may be completely normal in your book, but it sure as hell don't look very normal to me. And I knew him when he was normal. What the fuck are you doing to him? Billy! Billy! Don't just walk straight by me as though you don't recognize me. What's going on?
What's wrong, Gina?
Keep out of this.
No, Billy, I'm not going to let you have any more medicine till the next dose is due.
I need medicine.
No, Billy, try to understand. It'll damage your brain.
I need medicine now! Then send me out to kill. I can't stand it anymore.
Billy, don't do this to me. I'm doing what's best for you. Billy, I can do something else for you. Oh, Billy!
It's okay, I'm fine.
Would you like me to turn off your power for you?
No, leave it on. At least I can listen to the world.
Okay, then, I'll leave you to it.
Hi, you've got the Brain Book Center, and what can I do for you?
Oh, you want another one? You better go easy on it, man.
Because it'll mash your brain. Yeah, sure, I know you can handle it, just like they all can.
Man, some guys never learn. Come to me, baby, where you hiding? DA-27.
Ooh, that I dig.
Billy's getting too much fun out of killing Voomers. He's going down fast.
Do you think he's becoming too drug dependent?
That's possible.
I'm lecturing on Billy to the medical seminar later this week, so we better make sure he stays alive till then or we're out of a job.
And after that, what?
After that? He might be killed in the line of duty.
Huh?
In the line of duty.
We have no jurisdiction over that woman's activities. There's not a damn thing we can do about her.
Then Billy's as good as dead now. I mean, she's simply doing experiments on him so she can make her name. She doesn't give a damn about him or what happens to him or what the Voomers can do or anything but herself.
Well, suppose we get her off the scene. Will you take care of Billy?
Honey, you're too cute.
Goodbye. Catch you later.
Who was that?
Another delivery from the Brain Book Center. The creep makes me want to throw up.
The Brain Book Center?
Billy likes to listen to audiobooks. He buys a lot of them.
Huh?
Medicine.
Oh, Billy.
And I've seen a giant stride in our continuing struggle against the Voomers. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Takagi and our guest of honor, Billy Fernwood.
Billy, what's keeping you? Billy, are you okay? Hang in there. Come on, you've got to appear at the seminar. You've got to show them you're okay. You're all I have. I'll make it up to you.
It had to end like this.
Hey, I'm still waiting for clearance.
Hold on a second. What's up, Billy? What are you doing here?
Shit, what the fuck?
Diarc, it's Billy!
What's he doing? Is he going insane or what?
I can't feel anything. I can't feel anything.
Down to the furnace room. We'll have to follow him down and get him there.
All this much. I've gone insane. What am I going? Who am I? I can't remember. Who are these people? Why don't they stop me? Are they all too weak? Somebody kill me! Kill me!
Billy, stop!
Diorc!
It's okay, it's only a scratch. You gotta stop him. He's going completely off his head. Kill him. You've got no choice. Gina!
Yes, Diorc, I know. Take it easy.
I should have listened when you warned me. It wasn't Billy's fault, though.
Billy, you know I've got to stop you. Billy, I'm going to kill you.
Yes, kill me.
Get out of here!
Kill me, Gina. Please, shoot me in the brain. It doesn't understand anything anymore. I don't know what I'm doing. Somehow I know you, Gina.
Gina, he's too strong for you to stop him. Get out of here while you can.
Let me feel pain before I die. Let my mind feel pain. Remind me I'm human. My tongue, Gina. It's all I have left. Shoot my tongue.
No!
Gina, do you feel okay? It's over.
Is that what's in store for me? Is that how I'm gonna die?
Huh?
Am I gonna be what he became and die the same way as Billy?
We commit his body to the earth.
You know what? He was a pretty brave guy. Look, Leon. That's his mother. He knew he was giving his own life for the rest of us. Pretty brave guy.